Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
So today we are going to have an understanding about Damodar Ashtakam. थोड़ी बहुत इसके बारे में समझ लेते हैं, सुनते तो काफी हैं, गाते भी हैं, बट थोड़ा उसको अच्छे तरह से समझ लेते हैं। So let's understand first the Damodar Leela before we understand the Damodar Ashtakam. So Damodar Leela अगर समझना है बहुत आसान है। आप लोगों से कई लोगों ने सुना भी रहेगा Damodar Leela। कितने लोगों ने सुना है? काफी लोगों ने सुना हो। So just to brief you about it, ये लीला उस दिन घटा दिवाली के अगले दिन। Next day, this leela took place. And the specialty of this leela was early in the morning. Yashoda Maiya was churning butter for Krishna. She was making special butter. एकदम special butter बना रही थी Krishna के लिए, ताकि कृष्णा दूसरे घरों में जाकर मक्खन ही चुराए। तो he was famous for stealing butter. So कृष्णा ताकि बाहर जाकर न चुराए, इसके लिए she was churning out special butter. And that time all the housemaid servants and Yashoda Maiya herself, they were singing the song of the pastimes of the Lord. जो बचपन में जो लीलाएं करते थे उसी का गाते थे, और हाथ में जो मत्थे थे तो चूड़ियों की खन खन आवाज आती थी, वो करताल जैसा आवाज करता था। एंड ही यूज्ड टू डू द मंथन ऑफ द बटर। सो लॉर्ड गॉट अप, लॉर्ड वाज स्लीपिंग, ही गॉट अप एंड ही वांटेड टू हैव, ही वाज हंग्री एंड ही वांटेड टू हैव दिस मदर्स मिल्क। तो माँ के पास गया, यशोदा मैया ने तभी एक पॉट भर के दूध गर्म होने के लिए रखा, उबालने के लिए रखा, उसमें से कहीं उसको स्वीट्स बनाना था कृष्ण के लिए। सो शी टुक कृष्णा ऑन हर लैप एंड स्टार्टेड फीडिंग हिम
वेयर ब्रेस्ट। अचानक उसने देखा कि दूध उबल के आग में गिर रहा है, तो तुरंत वो चाहती थी दूध को बचाए, उसके लिए उसे नीचे रख दिया। इन दिस स्मॉल लीला देयर आर मेनी थिंग्स टू बी अंडरस्टूड। फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट, she kept the butter for the Lord, for specially for singing the glories of the Lord. What do we understand? Lord says in the Chaturu Shloki Bhagavad Gita, machita madgata pranam bodhenches parasparam kadenchesche mam nityam tushyanti cha ramanti cha. So what does we understand? Always the devotees of the Lord are praising the and talking about the Lord only, and that gives them tushyanti and ramanti. They gave them happiness and they get satisfaction. Secondly, when Yashoda Maiya saw the fire, the milk kept on the fire, the milk felt, now what is my use? What is my service to Lord? Agar main doodh rehta garam hone ke baad, agar Krishna ko pilati, to mera kuch seva hota. But now Krishna is drinking his mother's milk. So what is my use of staying alive? I better boil and fall in the fire and commit suicide. On the other hand, Yashoda Maiya was thinking, my dear milk, please don't wait, don't fall out. I'll sprinkle some water and save you, because I need you for Krishna's service in the form of a sweet. I'm going to make some sweet out of you and serve you. So we understand from this, ek bhakt दूसरे भक्त को सेवा के लिए ऊपर उठाता है। He helps one devotee, helps another devotee in coming up and in serving the Lord. Not that he is serving the Lord. Okay, your service is not required. He doesn't push it out. They go on jointly. They do the service. So this angered the Lord, and he broke the pot of yogurt which he was चरनी, जो मत रही थी उसे तोड़ दिया उसने, और तोड़ने के बाद उसे एहसास हुआ उसने क्या गलती किया। इमीडिएटली ही रैन अवे, वहां से भाग गए। कृष्ण का हमेशा तो लीला है भागने का, यहां वहां, तो भाग गए। एंड ही रैन आउट and he was sitting on a mortar, standing on a mortar, that is ukkal. And on from that, he was taking out butter and feeding it to the monkeys and crows. When we will come to that slide, I will explain you the significance why Krishna was feeding the monkeys and the crows. Why only them? What is so special about them? Then Yashoda Maiya came back and realized Krishna has broken the pot and he has run away, and she followed his footprints. She picked up a stick and decided to punish Krishna. So now we understand introduction of Damodar Ashtakam. So Damodar Ashtakam actually starts from the Leela at from that point. Despite the existence of other Smritis and Shastras such as Manusmriti and all, Vaishnava Smriti was waiting, and Lord Chaitanya asked Sanatana Goswami to make a Vaishnava Samhita or Vaishnava Achar book, where you can get the various principles of a Vaishnava, and then this was prepared by Sanatana Goswami with the help of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. That is why that book was called as Hari Bhakta Vilas. Hari Bhakta Vilas, Sanatana Goswami gives a lot of tikas or commentaries. Though this book itself is a commentary, but more than that, he has given commentaries on that book itself. That is why Hari Bhakta Vilas is very important. So, how many of you all know the importance of Damodar Ashtakam, from where it has been taken? Does anybody have an idea? It is taken from the Padma Puran. The Padma Puran had the Damodar Ashtakam. And in Hari Bhakta Vilas, Damodar Ashtakam has been very systematically been explained that. The intricacies of that has been explained in Hari Bhakta Vilas. No doubt, Padma Puran. Satyavrata Muni is the main person who has spoken this Damodar Ashtakam. Namamishwaram Satchitananda Rupam Rasat Kundalam Gokule Brajamanam Yashodhabi Yoluko Dhavayamanam Param Rishnam Atyanto Dhrutyate Gopaya. In this verse, we generally have this understanding of this verse and the so called meaning. But when you go to the word to word understanding, there you understand Namamishwaram Satchitananda Rupam. What is Lord trying to say? What is Satyavrata Muni trying to say? He devotionally first bows down to the Lord by saying Namam Ishwaram Satchit Ananda Rupam. So what do you understand from Satchit Ananda Rupam? Usse kya aapko samajh mein aata? Hum log kabhi baar Hindi filmon mein bhi sune Satchit Ananda, Satchit Ananda. To kya hai ye Satchit Ananda? What is the Satchit Ananda? This is the three, generally people know, it is known as Sat stands for eternal, Chit stands for knowledge, and Anand stands for bliss. But the higher understanding is, it is also standing for Brahman, Paramatma and Bhagavan. It is standing for the three phases or the three Rupa of the Lord. So from this, Satyavrata Muni is starting praising the Lord as Sat, Chit, Anand. Then, Lasat Kundalam Gokule Brajamanam. Because of Lord's mercy, the two earrings are fortunate to kiss his cheeks and take part in the childhood pastimes of the Lord. You think everyone can become a part of the Lord's Leela? Can everyone get a chance to become a part of the Lord's Leela? To become even a servant in Amitabh Bachchan's house, everyone desires. Everyone wants to get connected to some big personality. So just imagine the good luck of the earrings. Then another meaning is, this earring shines not because this is shining, but the beauty is enhanced because of the Lord. The Lord's beauty is enhancing the beauty of the earring. Uddhava states in the third canto, the Lord is spellbound by the splendor of his own body, which is an ornament of all ornaments. So Lord's body itself is so beautiful, it's an ornament by its own. It's an ornament of its all ornaments. In this slide we can see Krishna is standing on the ukkal and feeding the monkeys butter and to the crows also he is feeding. It signifies, it is said in the Shastra, they are vanished from those who were in the Ramayana, those monkeys who took part in Ramayana, their ancestors, and the crows were from the ancestor of Kagabhushandi. Kagabhushandi was the main person, in one of the main rishi in the Leela of Ramayana, and unke vanshaj the kauve. To iske liye kauvon ko aur monkeys ko wo butter khilate the. Now Gokule Brajamana, he shines in Gokul, the land of gopis and the gopas, the cow and the calves. Now Paramrishtam Atyanta Drute Gopya, the word she caught him from behind also hints that he is his special affection for her. You can catch Lord only from behind, you can never overtake the Lord and go ahead of him. भगवान के आप आगे निकल नहीं सिखाते, हाँ उनके पीछे जरूर आके पकड़ने की कोशिश जरूर कर सकते हैं. एंड ऑल्सो इट वॉज हैम्पर्ड बाई हर ब्रॉड हिप्स, शी वॉज ओल्ड. यशोदा मैया वॉज नॉट अ यंग लेडी, शी वॉज एन ओल्डिश लेडी, शी वॉज इन हर अर्ली 50s. दैट्स वॉट आई हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम द कमेंट्रीज फ्रॉम सीनियर्स. एंड दैट एज शी वॉज फाइंडिंग इट डिफिकल्ट टू रन, वो बहुत मुश्किल से भाग पा रही थी. फिर भी भगवान को पकड़ना कि सबके बस का काम है क्या, फिर भी वो भाग रह के पकड़ने की कोशिश कर रही थी. तो भगवान ने बोला ठीक, एंड फाइनली ड्रॉप्ड हर हैंड. उसके बालों से फूल गिर रहे थे, पसीने छूट रहे थे, उसकी हालत खराब हो गई थी, और फिर भी वो भाग रही थी. एंड देन फाइनली शी कॉट हिम फ्रॉम बिहाइंड. We can catch the Lord only in His manifested form. If you want to catch the Lord, it is only possible in the Bhagavan Swarupa. In the Brahman Swarupa, you cannot catch God. In the Paramatma Swarupa, yogis have been trying to catch Lord for so many thousands of years, but they have not been able to catch Krishna. The only reason is one should have the personal form, his personal form, then only you can catch. Yeah, when we will only catch him when we have sufficient eagerness within us. But first, the urge for mundane pleasure is more for us. हमारे लिए द अर्ज फॉर गेटिंग अ नाइस मोबाइल, अ नाइस कार, अ नाइस हाउस, अ नाइस वाइफ, अ नाइस चाइल्ड इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस देन द ईगरनेस फॉर गेटिंग द लॉर्ड. इनफैक्ट आई वंडर, आई एटलीस्ट टू माई सेल्फ आई कैन से आई डोंट हैव एन ईगरनेस, मच ऑफ ईगरनेस. सो द ईगरनेस शुड बी टू द टॉप मोस्ट, देन ओनली वन कैन गेट लॉर्ड. But we are missing this eagerness. Secondly, Lord says, it is said in the Shastra, Anya Bilashita Shunyam Jnana Karma Adi Anavratam Anukulena Krishna Anushilana Bhaktir Uttamam. Now, can anyone explain to me the meaning of Anya Abhilashita? It is not Abhilasha, it is Abhilashita. Shitta stands for the propensity to have any other desires, not desire. It is not one, because one desire is fulfilled, you will have a second desire. When second desire is fulfilled, you will have the third desire. So that propensity to have desires other than that of Krishna is dangerous. That is not good for bhakti. So that is what is Lord, we are trying to understand in this Damodar Ashtakam. Very nicely Lord is saying, if you want to catch me, you should have that eagerness. This eagerness is generally missing in us. Sadhakas have got eagerness, but still that level is not there. So here we go to text number 2. Rudam tam muhur netram yugvam rijantam karam bhoja yugmena shataka netram मुहूर् श्वास कंपाति रेखा कंठम सित ग्रेव दामोदर भक्ति बादाम.
Yeah, by the way, before I go ahead, I would like to understand how many people can understand this verse, I mean the first verse, by Yashodhabi Iloka Dhavayamanam. How do you understand this? Yashodhabi is one word. And Uluka means stands for Ukala, for the motor. So we have to understand it by systematically breaking the words, and then we can understand this very nicely. Satyavrata Muni has really composed it. It's from the Padma Puran, it's not from an ordinary scripture. So it's really great. So here, having been caught, he was sobbing and rubbing his eyes, frightened. The word used is Shataka Netram. Rudantam Muhur Netram Yugmam Rajantam Karam Bhoja Yugmena Shataka Netram. Muhur Shwasha Kampa. Muhur Shwas means, you know, small children, when they are afraid, they take small breaths. Lord taking these breaths. Mind you, the killer of so many asuras, and he is taking, he is crying like this. And the beauty of it is Kampa. Kampa means trembling. And what does Bhagavatam say? Bhagavatam gives a very nice explanation. Bhagavatam says, Apna naam samsiddha ghoram, yan naam vivaso granam, yat sadhaya vimuchyate, yat bibhit swayam bhayam. What does this verse mean? Apna naam samsiddha ghoram, one who takes your name just like that, unknowingly, by default he takes your name. Apna naam samsiddha ghoram, yan naam vivaso granam. This always he is chanting, or he takes it only once in a while. Tat sadhaya vimuchyate, he is freed from fear. Why? Yat bibhit swayam bhayam, fear himself fears. And that name is so powerful. Just imagine the Lord kitne powerful rahenge. And wo Lord aaj kampa mein hai. He is shivering in front of his mother. That's the beauty of the verse. And weeping again and again, he is rubbing his eyes, and all the kajal which was there in his eyes was flowing out. Because Yashoda Maiya used to apply a lot of kajal to him. Kahin usko nazar na lag jaye. So that was coming out. So this verse gives a very nice understanding of that. And here, finally, Bhakti Badam. She ties him up to the Ukala. Mind you, she has tied the Supreme Personality of Godhead with the Ukala. Now, when she is tying it up, generally we have heard in many lectures, there are two things which is required for one to tie up the Lord. One is determination, and two is the mercy of the Lord. Do cheez chahiye. That is why when she was tying the Lord with the Ukala, it was running two fingers short. Mind you, usne ghar ka hi rasi nahi, agal bagal se bhi rasi leke aaye. She got all the rasi available in Vrindavan, in Gokul, and she was trying to tie Krishna. But every time she was trying, it was going two fingers short. So generally we hear this, or there is a main understanding is determination and mercy of the Lord. Sometimes our determination is not firm, and many sadhakas fall into trap, again becoming involved in enjoying Maya things, thinking I will work hard, make lot of money, build a house, live comfortably, but they forget that one day they have to die and leave everything behind. This is the problem with the sadhaka. The sadhaka doesn't understand. Sometimes he falls into Maya. Theek hai. You know, you need drid nischay. Only the person who has got a firm determination, he can achieve the end goal. Even in the material world, you need to have a firm determination. First, so Lord also checks our determination. Lord checks how determined you are. हम लोग कई बार बोलते हैं, हम कई दिनों से हम लोग भक्ति कर रहे हैं, बट क्या हो रहा है, अभी तक भगवान का कृपा नहीं मिला है या भगवान मिले नहीं हमको. बट पीपल डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द डिटर्मिनेशन हैज टू बी स्ट्रॉन्ग. Secondly, first Yashoda thought that she would easily wrap the rope around Krishna's waist. But did it happen? Similarly, when we first take up devotional life, we think attaining Bhagwan will not be difficult. हम लोग सोचते हैं बहुत आसानी से भगवान मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु जी तीन चार चीज करने हैं, चार परहेज करना है, चार चीज करना है और माला है, भगवान का नाम लेना है एंड वी विल बी वेरी क्लोज टू गॉड वेरी सून. बट थिंग्स डोंट हैपन दैट इजी. सो वी टेक अप दिस एंड वी फाइंड इट टू बी डिफिकल्ट, बट रिकॉग्नाइजिंग रियलिटी ऑफ इट, वी शुड नेवर बिकम डिस्पोनेंट. Many devotees become despondent, but we should always remain eager and determined. Let's understand the story of Parashar Bhatt. Then we'll understand the qualities of a devotee. What qualities we as devotees should have. Very nice understanding is, once Parashar Bhatt's one student asked him, Guruji, what is the quality of a devotee? Ek bhakt ke andar kaun se gun hone chahiye, jo use achha bhakt banayega? Immediately, Parashar Bhatt told him, go to my friend, Singh, Anantacharya, who is staying in Tirupati. And in those days, there was no car, rickshaw, no flight and all those stuff. So he had to walk all the way from Srirangam to Tirupati to meet Anantacharya. So it took him a couple of months to reach over there. After reaching over there, Anantacharya asked him, why have you come? He told him, मुझे भक्त के लक्षण जानना चाहता हूं. Was it very good? So one thing you do, you stay, now you must be tired, you take some rest, prasad vasad kha lo, and then tomorrow you can do some service to Lord Balaji, and then I will tell you. So roj, every day morning, he used to get up thinking that today I am going to get the secret of the answer. What is the quality of a good devotee? So it went on like this for nearly a couple of months. And this fellow was serving there very sincerely and very hard. One day, after a few months, there was a big annakoot in the temple and a big festival was there. So, bahut sare log aaye the. And he was given the in charge of prasadam department. The devotee was given the in charge of prasadam department. He told him, you go and serve prasadam for everyone. So hundreds and hundreds of people, right from morning, he was serving prasadam. And finally, it was evening at 5 o'clock when he himself got a chance to eat. So usne apna thali banaya, badi achhi tarah se sajaya aur baitha. And itne mein Anantacharya came and he said, you had asked me some question. I think I should answer you today. He was so excited. सुबह से थका था, भूख लगी थी, बट फिर भी उसने प्लेट तुरंत छोड़ दिया एंड ही वेंट नियर अनंताचार्य. ही सेड, यस प्लीज टेल मी व्हाट आर द क्वालिटीज ऑफ अ डिवोटी, एक भक्त के क्या गुण होने चाहिए. ही सेड, एक भक्त शुड बी लाइक ए चिकन, लाइक ए क्रेन, लाइक सॉल्ट एंड लाइक यू. व्हाट अ डिसअपॉइंटमेंट टू हिम. आफ्टर 4-5 months ऑफ सर्विस एंड होल डे वर्किंग, एंड जो प्लेट हाथ में था उसको भी छोड़ के आ गया पहले पीछे मानदाचार्य को पूछने के लिए. एंड दिस इज वॉट इज सींग, चिकन क्रेन, वॉट इज दिस? ही कुड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द आंसर. फाइनली ही डिसाइडेड, लेट मी गो बैक टू माई टीचर एंड आस्क हिम. सो ही वेंट अगेन अनदर 2-3 months इट टुक हिम टू गो बैक टू हिज टीचर श्रीरंगम. एंड ही आस्क्ड हिम, ही सेड, यस आई नो, ही हैज गिवन अ कोडेड आंसर, नाउ आई विल डीकोड इट फॉर यू. It was very easy to understand this. I could have told you this answer here itself, but I wanted you to understand it from him. Now I'll tell you what is the answer. You should be like a chicken. How is a chicken? It goes to a dump of lump of trash and segregates its thing of choice. It is very particular. It never eats trash. It picks up the things what it wants. Perfect. You see a chicken, you mix it up with some dirt or something, it will pick up the things which it wants. Second is crane. You have seen crane standing in the water on one leg. And what is he doing? Meditating. Some like a yogi. No. He is focused. Some big fishes come. He knows he cannot gulp it down. Leaves it. Some small fishes come. They are too small for me. He leaves it. He waits for the right size of fish for it to come. And the minute it comes, it swims now and takes it up. Now these fishes are compared to fishes of Mayavad, fishes of Brahmavad, fishes of yogis, siddhis, those, all these things will come when you are in devotional service. But provided you are focused on what you want to take. Things will come, many things will float in the water, but one like a crane, you should be focused. Then third, salt. Now what do we understand from salt? Let's say we go to a nice prasadam hall and we are having nice prasadam, and there the prasadam or the food is not having right quantity of salt, either less or more. Would you praise it or will you point your finger at the salt in the food? But if the salt is perfect, you will praise the food and not the salt. So a devotee should be like salt. He should not take the praises, but he should be ready to take those things for his correction. That is why it says very nicely, Tranadapi suni chena tarorapi saishuna amanina manadena kirtanya sadahari. And last but not the least, he told him he should be like him. What does that mean? It means he should be as eager, a devotee should be as eager at that person. He went all the way from Srirangam to Tirupati, served the Lord and served the Vaishnavas over there for a couple of months, and that day he was so tired. And when his answer was to be given, he didn't say, okay Prabhuji or okay Maharaj, I'll come after some time, let me have my prasad first. He left the plate and immediately went to him for the answer. So from this we understand the qualities of a devotee. We say eagerness. Do we have eagerness of this sort? That is what eagerness was required to catch the Lord. Saradam Goswami says that there are two types of devotees. Those who desire to attain Bhagavan by the practice of sadhana. And second is those by waiting for the mercy of the Lord. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says both are required. Any one will not do. You require both the mercy of the Lord as well as your enthusiasm and determination has to be there. The word Bhakti Bhadam is very, very important. It signifies she could tie Krishna to the ukhal only by the rope of Bhakti. If one doesn't have Bhakti, you cannot tie the Lord. It is impossible to tie the Lord because He is supreme. You are Anu, He is Vibhu. So if you want to tie Him, you need Bhakti. And without this, it is next to impossible. Reasons of the Lord getting bound. Damodar means a rope on the abdomen, and describes, and as described in the Bhagavatam, then she bound him with a rope to the motor as if he were an ordinary child. The rope mutually tied the belly and the motor. This incident again emphasizes Sri Krishna's supreme position, but his perspective of a peculiar dependence. Krishna is also dependent, but dependent on one thing. Srimad Bhagavatam 10.9.2, Brihad Bhagavatam 7.2.130. How many of you all have studied Brihad Bhagavatam by any chance? Brihad Bhagavatam is an conversation between Mother Uttara and Parikshit Maharaj. It is said, to give you a very concise way of understanding, his last 7 days were left with Parikshit Maharaj. So he was without not eating food, and he did not take any water, and he heard the entire Bhagavatam from Sukhdev Goswami. After hearing that, it was completed, some time was left, and he was in a jolly mood. In a happy mood. So his mother Uttara asked him,
How could it be a person who's going to die, who has not eaten food for 7 days, not taken water for 7 days, he be happy? And then he explains, she asked him, what Amrit did Sukhdeva Goswami give you that has made you so happy? And finally, he gives this Brihad Bhagavatamrita. Neither Brahma, neither Shiva, and nor even Lakshmi Devi, who eternally resides in the Krishna's chest in the form of the golden line, ever received such mercy as Yashoda did from he who is bestower of liberation. So one thing understand, mercy has to be earned and not demanded. Generally people do the opposite. Lord, I have done so many years of service to you, so many upvasas I have done for you, so much of donation I have given you, and so much of things I have done for you, so now it's time that you send an white aeroplane for me to pick me up. It's not that way. In what way did he did not give the mercy to Brahma? He did the Brahmo Vimohan Leela. He confused Brahma, but he did not give him the mercy. He wanted to see, is he the same Lord? And there he got confused. As respect to Shiva, Krishna himself prayed to Lord Shiva to get Samba as a child. So some people may say, oh, Krishna himself is praying to Shiva, so Shiva is supreme. No, he confused Shiva. And last, Lakshmi Devi. We all know Lakshmi Devi is still waiting out of Vrindavan to enter into Vrindavan, but she has not yet got an entry ticket into Vrindavan. So from this we understand that mercy has to be earned and not demanded. Furthermore, the Lord says, the Lord thought, Sri Narada, my dear devotee, I shall grant these two sons of Kuvera whatever he has promised them. Now let's go into the little backtrack of the things. This Damodar Leela, finally, as you all know, the Ukhal is being pulled between two trees and the two trees get uprooted. Now who are those two trees? Son of Kuvera. So they were cursed by Narad Muni because they were in an intoxicated state and in a nude state rather, in front of a Maharishi like Narad Muni. So Narad Muni cursed them, may you become trees. But one has to understand, curses of Rishis and Vaishnavas is the best boon. You have to wait, but finally the curse gets benedictions. They became trees, Arjuna trees in Vrindavan, and finally Lord told them, Narad Muni told them, don't worry, when Krishna will come, he will liberate you. And finally, this was what the feeling of Lord Krishna, that my devotee has given a promise. And Lord always says, Kaunteya Pratijani Name Bhaktya Pranashati. Lord says, Arjuna, you proclaim, whatever devotees proclaim, I fulfill. I may break my words. He had told in Mahabharata, मैं अपना शस्त्र नहीं उठाऊंगा, but उन्होंने भीष्म को मारने के लिए चैरेट का व्हील उठाया, but to keep up the words of his devotees, he will break his promise also, because भीष्म himself was a great devotee, great Mahajan. So from this we understand, Krishna wanted to fulfill the promise given by Narad Muni to the two sons of Kuvera. Third verse. By such pastimes, he flooded Gokul in a lake of bliss, and he revealed to those in awe for his majesty that devotees can conquer him out of love. I chant his glory hundreds of times. Now you must be wondering, what's so great about this? The great Leela behind this is, the word iti means, has got lot of meaning in this word. Iti Drikswa Leela. The word iti means in this way. It relates to the present verse, to the Lord's dependence on his devotees. In this way, when the Lord was bound to the Ukhala, he was dependent on his devotees. The second understanding is, therefore, he is showing such dependence to his devotees, he flooded Gokul with a lake of bliss, Ananda Kunde, like we have got Shama Kund, Radha Kund over there. This is Ananda Kund, a kund full of bliss. Alternatively, iti can be related to this verse, to the pastime of being bound with the rope,
and then meaning could be by such charming infancy pastimes he flooded Gokul in the lake of bliss. So iti has got can be understood two ways, but this is what we can get an understanding very easily. Bhagavatam describes sometimes Lord used to be incited by the gopis, would sing loudly, dance at their will like a wooden puppet. Sometimes he would try to carry a wooden seat, wooden sandal or another weight as a test of strength, and then unable to accomplish the task he would toss his arms in defeat to the delight of his kingsfolk. Krishna, the Supreme Personality, carrying Nand Baba's slippers, and that also becomes a big weight for him. He cannot carry and he will keep it down. It's too heavy for me to carry. Who is carrying all the Brahmandas? The one who is carrying all the Brahmandas, who carried the Govardhan just by his tip of his last finger of his left hand. And there are so many Babas nowadays claiming that they are also gods. So, from this we understand, Lord wanted to only give bliss to his devotees. That was the main idea behind it. Verse 4. Varam deva moksham na moksham vadem va na chayanam vrane naham prasadapiha idam te vapurnata gopal balam sadame manas avrishtam kim anyahi. Very nice words of understanding. Oh divine Lord, although you are competent to grant any boon, now I don't cherish liberation nor life in Vaikuntha nor any other privilege. Oh Lord, be always present in my mind as Balagopal in Vrindavan. What will then be the value of other blessings? So this must have shattered many devotees. Why should I take moksha also? In fact, many people must be fed up of this material world, and they must have wanted to take freedom from this world. But here, Satyavrata Muni is saying something else. So let us understand this. Varam deva moksham na moksham vadimva. Satyavrata Muni says in the first part of the verse, although you could grant any boon, I am not entertaining the first four goals of human life. What are the first four human goals of human life? Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Liberation, even the topmost. Moksham vadimva. Moksha is liberation. Moksham vadimva is staying in the spiritual world. That is placed in Vaikuntha. So Lord says, Satyavrata Muni says, I am not interested in your spiritual world, which is the ultimate happiness experience. And I am not hankering for other, na anyam, others bhi mujhe nahi chahiye. Achievements, I don't want any other achievements desired by others. Our eternal life in the spiritual planet is superior to liberation. As expounded in the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, second part, ninefold Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, the ninefold bhakti is in turn higher achievement than the spiritual realm. We think spiritual realm is the ultimate, but ninefold bhakti is higher as per the understanding. In Tapaloka, he gives this explanation. In Brihad Bhagavatamrita, this comes. So let us take birth, even it is saying in the statement comes as, let us take birth in an infernal form, provided we remember the lotus feet, proves that the absorption in Shravanam, Kirtanam, etc. is more desirable than life in Vaikuntha. It is better desired to have a life of Shravanam, Kirtanam than life in Vaikuntha, because spiritual world is everywhere where such absorption is there. So that's why, you know, many times Rukla Sproji also gives in the lecture, he tells, if make your house as a temple, make your house as a place where you do the Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, and automatically it becomes a Vaikuntha. You don't have to go in search of Vaikuntha. House itself can be made into a Vaikuntha just by doing this Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam. You know, with us, there is a big problem. We devotees, calling ourselves so-called devotees. Sukadeva Goswami in Bhagavatam gives a very nice understanding. He says, Shrotavyadin Rajendra, he says, we have got thousands and thousands of things to be heard, but we cannot see Atma Tattvam, Apashyatam Atma Tattvam. We do not see the Atma Tattvam. Griheshu Graha Medinam. We call ourselves Grahastha, but actually we are Graha Medis. What Graha Medis? Next verse he says, Nidriya Harate Naktam, Vaya Venacha Vayaha, Divacha Artha Iha Rajan, Kutumba Bharane Nava. He says, we are busy filling the stomach of the family members. We are not interested in other things. That is why first verse he says, Apashyatam Atma Tattvam. And then what does these things lead to? They are only leading to Deha Aptya Klatra Adishu. What is this Deha? Body. Kalatra means Deha Aptya. Aptya means child and Kalatra means wife. Our life revolves against only in these three things. Deha Aptya Kalatra Adishu. Atma Senyeshu Atatsu Api. They are called as Atma Senyu. Whenever someone falls sick, he first call up his wife, call up his child, thinking that they are his Atmaka Sainya, soldier. What soldier? At the time of death, can anyone save you? No one can save you. Atma Sainishu Asat, not Sat, Asat Suapi. Then, Tesam, Pramada Nidhanam. These attachment only causes Pashyan Api Na Pashyati. And then, next verse, Sukadeva Goswami gives a very good understanding. That's why he says, Parama Bhagavan Ishwarah. And then he says, Shrotavyasya Kirtavyasya cha Smartavyasya cha Ichyate Abhayam. Those who want to become Abhaya, they require Shrotavya, Kirtavya and Smartavya. And these three things are always missing. We have Shrotavya for unwanted things, Kirtana of worldly gossips, and Smartavya means we remember. Sometimes we remember God, most of the times we forget God. So this is the difference we get. Here one more point is left. So Krishna may ask, which boon would you choose? He replies, Idam te Bapurnatha Gopala Balam. I want this childhood form of yours always fixed in my mind. And why he says mana? What is the great part in mana? Why it should go in the mind? Not in the heart. We can have it in the heart also, but why in the mind?
This is the one which controls everything.
Lord says in the Bhagavad Gita, Mai eva mana ajasva, mai buddhir niveshaya. Lord clearly says, only one thing Lord is asking is your mind. We are not competent enough to give anything else to Him. We are only competent enough to give our mind, provided we are doing proper devotional service. So Lord says very nicely. Even Lord says, Mai aveshit mano yemam, nitya yukto upasate, sradhya pariyopeta, teme yukto tamo mataha. So Lord says two times in the 12th chapter, twice he tells, and the heading of the chapter is devotional service. Twice Lord says, give me your mind. And that is the only thing we don't want to give. Our mind is on worldly things, our mind is on office, you name it, wife, family relations, children, everything. You know, what's the difference between us and the gopis? Why gopis are different to us? Gopis have to take special efforts to forget Krishna. And we have to take special efforts to remember Krishna. That is the biggest problem with us. हमको है ना एक्स्ट्रा एनर्जी लगाना पड़ता है कृष्ण के बारे में. हाँ, सोचना है मुझे कृष्ण के बारे में सोचना है. और गोपियों को कृष्ण को कैसे भूले हैं इसके लिए दे हैव टू टेक स्पेशल एफर्ट्स, बट दे आर नॉट सक्सेसफुल इन दैट आल्सो, दे फॉरगेट. सो दैट्स द डिफरेंस. सो वी हैव टू इन्वेस्ट आवर माइंड ऑन द लॉर्ड. दैट्स व्हाई ही सेज
Satyavrata Muni says very nicely, this mind should be fixed on this Gopal Balam.
Your lotus face is framed in dark crimson blue hued curls and decorated by lips as red as bibba fruits. May this visage, kissed again and again by Mother Yashoda, always be manifested in my mind. Then to what veil will millions of moons be? So now, and let us understand this. Cha gopya muhush chumbitam. The meaning is, may this lotus face, kissed again and again by Yashoda, may enter my mind again, alternatively. If we think the sequence of the word muhur is a syntax with the chumbitam only, then the meaning is, she is blessed with a rare fortune, she can kiss him again and again. May Lord's lotus face enter my mind at least once. See how lucky Yashoda Maiya will be to kiss the Lord again and again. She is such a blessed lady. So much of mercy Lord has poured on her. And Satyavrata Muni says very nicely. And the word sada, if you are dragging from the previous verse, the word sada is used. Then we understand, may this lotus face kissed again and again by Yashoda always enter my mind. So if you understand it analytically from the last verse, we take the sada word, that also understands the same. The compound bimbar raktam, rakta adaram, having lips as red as bimba fruits, is used as an adjective for the beauty of his face. And therefore, thousands of other boons are insignificant. 6. Namo Deva Damodar Vishnu, Ananta Vishnu, Prasida Prabho Dukkha Jalabdi Magnam, Kripa Adrishti Vishtya Dinam Batanu, Grihaneshu Mam Ajyam Ekhi Ashya Dishtay. Does anyone have an idea of how a prayer is, or a stuti is made? How is a prayer consisting of what format? A prayer has got three things in line. First is Samprathmika, second is Dainya Bodhika, and last is Lalsamai. This is how you see any prayers you take. It may be in one verse or it may be in the whole verse. First will be Samprathmika. What does this mean? You praise the Lord. One praises the Lord in the first half. In the middle, he shows his Dainya Sthiti, his very miserable condition. And last, they say, is Lalsamai, the desire of the devotee. This is how any prayer is made. This verse is a perfect example of that. Let us understand it in a more better way. After glorifying Lord as Namo Deva Damodar Ananta Vishnu Prasida Prabho, so many attributes have been given to the Lord. Very nicely he has given all these attributes. Expressing his fallen position, he says, Jalabda Dukkha Jalabdi Magnam Ati Dinam Agyan Mamam. Mom, so what does this mean? I am drowned. Dukkha Jalabdi. Jalabdi means ocean. Ocean of birth and death. And you know, na, wo, Bhavsagar jise kehte hain. Us Jalabdi, wo bhi dukha wala Jalabdi. Again, again taking birth, again and again. And Ati Dinam. I am not Dinam, Ati Dinam. And last, Agyanam. I am drowned in a perpetual ocean of birth and death. Or I am afflicted by the pangs of separation from your vision. I feel utterly miserable. I am utterly ignorant. Hence, unable to find any solution. So, first line, he praised first two lines. Then he is talking about his Dainya Sthiti. And last, then the grace he expects. Kripa Drishti Vishtya Anugraha. Please look at me with mercy again and again. Or shower upon me the nectar of your merciful glance and revive me. But finally he clearly asserts his desire. Edi Akshi Drishya, please appear before me. That is the final crux he wants to give, but he is not giving it abruptly. He expresses his plea only gradually, because the last request is so lofty. that it would be improper to mention it abruptly. So directly, people go to the temple. Bhagwan, maine 10 rupaye dal diya hai. Ye mera list of demand hai, charter of demands hai. Please, iske jaldi pura kar dijiye. Generally, we go with such type of people. We go out with that type of attitude. But even when you are praying for a materialistic gain, forget about a spiritual gain, materialistic gain also, you have to follow this system. First, praise the Lord. Declare your dainya sthiti. And last is, you get the, put forth your lalsa mai, whatever lalsa you are having, you put forth. Kubir atma jo baddho. This is very important. Damodar. Damodar. While tied to the motor, you redeemed the two sons of Kubera and granted him bhakti. Similarly, bestow upon me prema bhakti, but I shall not accept liberation. Again, Satyavrata Muni is stating the same thing. Now let us understand this also in a better manner. Kubera atma jo. While bound with ropes to the motor, Sri Krishna dragged it in between the two Yamala trees. And the motor was stuck and he uprooted the trees by pulling it. The son of Kuber were thus delivered from the curse of Narada and from the cycle of birth and death. Not only that, they obtained supreme devotion as well. Therefore, he says, Bhakti Bhajo Kritavcha. You got bhakti along with liberation. Satyavrata Muni says, Tatha prema bhaktim swakame prayach. Similarly, you know, bachche log bolte na, mummy, bhaiya ko tumne diya hai, mujhe bhi do. Kisi aur ko diya, mujhe do. Aapne unko diya, mujhe bhi do. To usi tarah, Satyavrata Muni says, O Damodar, in the same way, give me the exclusive shelter of your lotus feet. That is, Lord may suggest, why you are neglecting liberation? इन उसमें तो जन्म मृत्यु का चक्कर शायद छूट भी सकता है या नहीं छूट सकता है. सो यू कैन एक्सेप्ट इट अलोंग विद डिवोशन, जैसे मैंने नलकुबेरे को दिया. यू कैन एक्सेप्ट बोथ जन्म लिबरेशन एज वेल एज यू कैन एक्सेप्ट भक्ति. बट देन इफ एन इंटेलिजेंट पर्सन इज देयर, ही नोस इफ ही इज हैविंग ए चिंतामणि विथ हिम, व्हाई वुड ही नीड सम अदर जेम अलोंग विथ इट. That is inclusive of everything. So if you have bhakti of the Lord, liberation is included in it. You don't have to separately ask for it. So this is what you understand from this. Lord, why Satyamuni is saying, I don't need liberation separately. This is enough for me. Only bhakti is enough. Because this is included in this. Eighth verse. Namaste sudhamne spuradhid vidhamne. So, my respect to this great roof, reservoir of dazzling effulgence, and to your belly, which contains the entire cosmos. Obeisance to you, beloved Srimati Radharani. Lord, I bow down to you, the transcendental hero of these divine and eternal pastimes. Now, suddenly Radharani's name comes in this verse, which was not that long. In this verse, Satyavrata Muni is glorifying both the rope and the belly, which is very, very source of the universe, which was tied by Yashoda. Also, to sum up with the Vrindavan Leelas would be incomplete without Srimati Radhani, who is most dearer and eternal to her, to him. So, you know, when Lord is saying all this, he wants to mean, you know, the ending of, this is the last verse of the Ashtakam. Ashtakam means eight. Eight verses means Ashtaka. The last verse. So it should like a meal completing with a sweet. So he is giving a sweet. Radharani is so sweet. And not only that, all the Leelas which has happened in Vrindavan, Ananda Leela, that is what he is saying. The verse clearly says, Namaste sudhamne spuradhidhamne tatayo visham namo radhikaya tivana namo ananta leelaya devayatubhyam. Namo ananta leelaya, all the leelas what you have done in Vrindavan, I respect them. Now, why is he trying to glorify the rope? He has already glorified the kundala. In the first verse itself, the kundala was glorified. Then what is the need to glorify the rope? The rope is tying the abdomen of the Lord, the belly of the Lord. And what is the belly? From where the Kamal comes out, and the floating planetary systems are there inside that. You know, it's a very nice understanding in Kunti Stuti. You know, the Stuti states like, Namaste Pankajangre, Namaste Namo Pankajanabhaya, Namo Pankajamalini, Namaste Pankajangre. That is the verse which says that I bow down to the belly, to the Pankaj Nabhaya and Namo Pankaj Malini. One has to understand this. What is this lotus referring to? It is referring to the various Brahmanda. Lord, from each pore, Brahmandas are coming. And each Brahmanda, Lord's navel, you are getting the lotus. So what is Lord trying to say in this? I mean, Satyavrata Muni trying to say. Or even in Kunti Stuti, what was Kunti Rani trying to say? Lord makes a garland of all these Brahmanda and moves around freely. Namo Pankaj Malini. He is putting a mala of all the Brahmandas and moving around freely. And agar aapke gale mein koi mala dal de, to aapko weight lage. So Lord is finding it so easy to carry so many Brahmandas around his neck. हम लोग यहाँ पे एक 10 किलो वेट उठाने को अपने को तकलीफ पड़ता है. ही इज कैरिंग सो मेनी ब्रह्मांडास. सो दैट नेवल हैज बीन टाइड बाय द रोप. सो ही इज ग्लोरिफाइंग बोथ द रोप एज वेल एज द नेवल. पद्म पुराण सेस टू वर्शिप श्री राधा दामोदर द प्रिसाइडिंग डीटी ऑफ दिस मंथ. वी शुड वर्शिप श्री राधा दामोदर एज द प्रिसाइडिंग डीटी ऑफ दिस मंथ. Shri Radha Radhika is Lord Hari's favorite among the gopis. Therefore, during Kartik, she should be worshipped next to Damodar. During Kartik, one should worship a Brahmana as Shri Damodar, his wife as Shri Radha, offering them garments, ornaments and eatables. Vasau Alankara Bhujau. Lord is, the verse clearly says, Vasau means ornaments, garments, Alankar stands for ornaments, and Bhojanau stands for food. So, the Brahmana as Shri Damodar, Hari is very pleased with the devotees who seek Shri Radharani's satisfaction by worshipping her murti during the month of Kartik. One should recite regularly the hymns sung by Satyavrata Muni called Damodar Ashtakam because this worship attracts Shri Damodar. Now, we are coming up to the end part, that is importance of Kartik months. What is so great about this Kartik month? Lot of WhatsApp moving around, messages moving around, ye karna chahiye, wo karna chahiye, but iska importance kya hai? You people tell the do's and don'ts, but nobody is telling what is the greatness. So let's understand from Skanda Puran and Padma Puran what is the importance. O Narada, best of the pious souls, after attaining this rare human form, whoever does not follow the duties prescribed in Kartik is like a murderer of his mother and father. One who wastes this month without undertaking any vrata is excluded from any religious duty and will be born in an animal species. Such an individual shall be accounted among the Brahmana murderers, cow slaughterers, gold thief and liar. If this person is a widow, hell is her secure destination, and if he is a householder, other pious deeds will be worthless and he will reside in hell until the dissolution of the universe. If he is a Brahmana, he will be neglected by all the demigods beginning from Indra. O great Brahmana, if this opportunity to perform Vrata during Kartik is neglected, all the pious merits amassed in the past are reduced to ashes. The study of the Vedas and Puranas become futile. Charity, japa and penance becomes fruitless, and serving and reaching Swarga becomes impossible, despite the performance of such countless sacrifice and hundreds of Shraddha ceremonies. So these are few words which are telling us the importance of Kartik month. You know, people generally talks about do's and don'ts. Whoever wastes this month of Kartik without undertaking any vow for Vishnu, O Narada, will not get the results of performing pious deeds. This is coming from Skanda Puran, dialogue between Brahma and Narada. O Narada, the merits and demerits obtained during Kartik are like river and mountain and oceans which can never get exhausted. Merits and demerits both can be got. Agar aap bhakti sahi dhang se karoge, to your merits will be 1,000 times. And if you don't do it correctly, demerits will also be there. Of 12 months, this month is particularly dear to Sri Krishna. Sri Vishnu certainly rewards the devotees who worship him during Kartik and with residence in his own abode, even if worshipped with minimum items. Damodar is famous for Bhakti Vatsala. He is and his month imbibes his characteristics. It rewards even a tiny effort with huge results. Of all living species, the human form achieved by the incarnated being and through this existence of this month of Kartik, which is so dear to Hari, even Kartik month is even rarer. Vows to be followed in Kartik. What are the main vows to be followed in Kartik? In this month, one should sleep on the floor, maintain celibacy, worship Sri Damodar, and eat only prasad. Is freed from all sins and will taste the bliss of Vishnu in Vaikuntha. If one doesn't visit Dham like one should visit Dham like Vrindavan, Mayapur, Jagannathpuri, etc., it enhances one's devotional life and benefits are multiplied in millions of times. That's why you see most of the devotees during Kartik month, they go to Dhams. By bathing at the dawn, controlling the senses, performing puja and eating prasadam throughout Kartik, one is freed from all sins. And by eating only once a day, he will become famous, strong and courageous. Virtues of offering Deepa. अभी हम लोगों ने सब मंदिर में दीप दिया, वॉट इज अ बेनिफिट? लोग कहते हैं अच्छा है अच्छा है, कितने दूर दूर से लोग आ गए, दीप दे ऑफर्ड दीप टू द लॉर्ड, वॉट इज द पर्पज बिहाइंड दिस दीप दान? लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दैट ऑल्सो. द सिन अक्यूमुलेटेड इन मिलियंस ऑफ कल्पा वैनिश इन एन इंस्टेंट व्हेन दीपा इज ऑफर्ड ड्यूरिंग कार्तिक. बाय ऑफरिंग अ दीप इन दिस मंथ, अ पर्सन विल नॉट टेक बर्थ ऑन अर्थ अगेन. This deep dhan bestows all the benefits such as there's available at Kurukshetra during the solar eclipse, Narmada during the lunar eclipse, multiplied by millions. This a great sage, oh great sage, what is the value of Ashwamedh sacrifice for someone who in this month lights a ghee or sesame oil lamp? By this offering to the Lord, all the prescribed activities, even if devoid of mantras and rituals and cleanliness, are brought to perfection. One may not be an expert in his mantras, one may not be expert even in his rituals practice, but just with Shraddha, if one offers deep to the Lord, he gets perfection. On the other hand, all the pious deeds of all the three worlds are not effective if the Kartik Deep does not burn before Lord Krishna. Moreover, even if the volume of one sin is equal to Mount Meru, this Deep Dhan will certainly incinerate them. Incinerating means we have something in chemistry called ash test, where you burn it to incinerate it to get the ash of it. You will get this incineration. No, even a speck of sin will not be left back. Everything will be gone. Be it in a temple of Lord Vishnu or in one private house, this offering yields amazing results. Indeed, the person who lights this deepa before Madhusuna is fortunate and glorious, because even hundreds of sacrifices and oblations in holy places cannot match the results instantly offered by a deepdan. So, this clearly states, you need not come to the temple. It's not that I am not stopping you from coming to the temple. But what I am saying is, you can do it in the house also. You may be staying far off, so you can do this process in the house. But do it. There is no way of, don't try to avoid this. For some bodily discomfort, don't try to avoid it. Do it. O Narada, in the three worlds, there is no sin that can stand before this Kartik Deep. In fact, by presenting this deep before Lord Vishnu, the eternal abode can be reached without any obstruction. कोई भी रुकावट नहीं आएगी आपको वैकुंठ यात्रा में. Deepa offered with camphor. All of us must be noticing the deepa is first dipped in camphor and then given to us, lighted and given to us. First we understood the value of giving a ghee deepa. Now we'll understand the value of dipping it in camphor and using it. Now I will tell you about the merits of acquired by one offering the deepa with camphor. Throughout Kartik or a particular day of Dwadashi, O Narada, all the born and or to be born members in one's family line, including all the innumerable forefathers, will enjoy in heaven for a long time according to their wishes and will attain liberation by the grace of Lord Hari, who has chakra in his hands. So the camphor is not meant only for you, it is meant for the lineage inside your family also. So when you do it in the house also, don't forget to put camphor on the diya, that is on the lamp, and then light it up. Many people think, oh, the camphor means it will catch up the light very fast, the fire burst. It's a misconception. It has got a separate significance. In this month, O great Brahmana, a person who illuminates Lord Keshava's temple, even for the sake of gambling, purifies his family up to 7 generations, and those who kindle this Kartik Deep in a temple of Lord Vishnu will prosper with wealth, progeny, good reputation and fame. Skanda Puran dialogue between the two. Virtue of reviving someone else's deepa. यहाँ पे हम मंदिर में ये भी सुनते हैं, आप समझो आपके पति या आपके घर वाले नहीं आ पाए तो उनका नाम का दिया भी आप घुमा सकते हैं. Then उसका क्या virtues है? Let us understand that also. All the results acquired by donating grains during Pitra Paksha or by distributing water in the month of Jyesh and Ashad are easily gained in the course of Kartik merely by reviving a deepa offered by someone else. Not by you, by someone else. In this month, the fruit of Rajasiyu and Ashwamedha sacrifice are attainable just by reviving another's deepa or by serving the Vaishnavas. O best of the kings, the person who revives deepa in the Hari temple shall never suffer Yamraj's torments again. So at least guarantee hai, Yamraj ka problem nahi aayega. And the last but not the least, the result of reviving someone else's deepa during Kartik cannot be obtained by any other means, not even by the great sacrifices. Once even a mouse attained a rare human form and reached the supreme destination after reviving a deepa on Ekadashi. Now how is this that a mouse can light a lamp? Aajkal chuhon ko to abhi tak matches chalana aaya nahi. It is said in one temple, a lamp was, you know, rats like ghee. They like to eat ghee. So someone had offered and kept the lamp in the temple. And the temple was closed, but the lamp was still burning a little. So it was like slightly, you know, it was just on the verge of getting over, but still it was burning. So this rat went to eat the ghee. Somehow it got stuck to his mouth and it got a little burnt. It started dancing because of the heat. Lord said, oh, this fellow is dancing with the deepa. Okay, let me liberate it. And it got liberated. And mind you, this is a story from the Quran. So this is even by mistake if someone does. The rat went, the mouse went to eat the ghee. No bhakti at all. But by mistake, it got stuck in its mouth. And because of the heat, the fire, it started dancing. So Lord said, oh, this fellow is dancing. So this is how one can revive his, I mean, get eliminated from all his past sins and at least progress towards devotional service. Just like center line. Oh, best of the king, the person who revives Krishna and Hari will never suffer Yamraj torment again.
What does it mean, Yamraj torment?
Yeah. Finally, Yamraj, Yampash has come, no?
Finally, the evil come.
No. For one who gets does this deep dan, this is a byproduct, not a product. There are two people. One is a devotee, one who is doing it with a devotional service, and the other person is just doing it like the rat. as the rat. That is why this rat example I have given specifically. The rat did not see any Yamraj, but Yamraj comes for even a rat, even for an ant, Yamraj comes. Even for a human being, Yamraj comes, because the karmas affected. But finally, a person who once offers diya in Hari's temple, he doesn't see Yamraj. If you have read Ajamil story, what did you understand in Ajamil story? It says very nicely, Sakrat mana krishnar padar vindayo tad niveshit guna ragayat yair giha. This is what Sukhdev Goswami is saying, this one verse. And to explain this one verse, he had to explain the entire Ajamil story. Na pashyati yamam pasham pratashchitat bhatan. He says, one who gives this, one who does sakrit, even unknowingly takes the name of the Lord, he doesn't have to see the Yamapasha, carriers of Yamapasha and the Yamapasha Dutas. He doesn't have to see that. And so explain this. That's why he says, atonement, we people do atonement. But atonement is of no use. The reason is, atonement you do for a particular activity or a particular sin. But it does not free you from the propensity of doing sins. The propensity of doing sins is there. It's like punishing one person for a specific one crime. But the better thing would be to make him atone for the propensity of doing that crime itself. That is what you understand. So with this, I would like to conclude this Damodar Leela and our understanding of this whole thing. But now you will ask me, Prabhuji, what about why the deep was offered? What is that significance with the story what you told us? So once the Yamala Aruja trees were separated and fallen off, the other household people came searching for Krishna, and it was night. Mind you, this Leela started in the morning, early morning, and ended in the night or twilight. And at that time, they came with diya searching for this. So this is that customary from those days, diya is being offered. So and if someone wants to ask one intelligent question, how many rounds should one offer? One should offer 7 rounds of this diya around the Lord, but should be shown to each and every deity in the temple. If he is doing in the house, he can do it very well in the house. There's no problem. Take an ordinary diya, apply a little camphor on it and show it to the Lord. The easiest and the best way of purifying yourself in progressing your devotional service. Hare Krishna.